My name is Ronald Davis. I've been on the street for about a year and a half now. Well, I come from the suburbs. Life, you know, which is rough. And I mean, I didn't sleep in the Lower Wacker. I didn't sleep on the bridges. I didn't sleep in the little cardboard boxes and stuff, you know, just surviving, especially in the wintertime is the hardest time. And like, I go to a few like applications for a job and stuff. They look at me, you know, I'm not looking presentable. And then they, well, we'll call you, leave a number. But how can I leave a number when I don't have a phone? So it's just a struggle out here, you know. I just, you know, from day to day, people, I come out here and panhandle with my cup right here at the Metro train station. People come off bringing me sandwiches and stuff like this here. And I start out in my morning about 6 o'clock. You know, sometimes I don't even have enough to go to the flop house. You know, sometimes the flop house is a cheap place and they number 16 bucks for 24 hours right over there on Clark and Van Buren. And a lot of times I don't have enough money for that, so I had to end up sleeping in the park or on one of these benches downtown or something like this. And then the security guards come and run you off about 5 or 6 in the morning. So by 6 o'clock I started panhandling and trying to survive. And like I said before, some days I don't even have enough to get it wrong, so I just sleep on the street. But I depend on the people that's coming off the train, because most of them I give them respect. You know, most of them like me. They come out and give me clothes and food and stuff like this here so I can survive. Give me a few bucks and everything, and I add it up at the end of the day and get me a little room for the night. And whenever I'm not fortunate enough to get the room, I just sleep in the street wherever I can. It's really humiliating to be shaking a cup 24 hours a day and people just look at you like you're some kind of little bum, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I have had people to walk past me and say, get a job, bum. And I said, wait a minute, I'm not a bum, I'm a human being. And it's hard. But after the end of the day, when people go home and everybody get on the Metro train, and then I just feel so bad that I can't be going home. You know, I'm sorry. But it's really emotional, because I'm really trying to get myself together and get off this tree. You know, and I don't care what it's doing. If I can get a job and through this humility, you know, I mean, you just lose all your humility when you're shaking a cup begging. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you can look at a person and tell if they getting your respect or not. You know what I mean? A lot of people look at you like you're just a piece of crumb. You know, I had one guy walk past me and talk about me so bad, and then I just looked at him. I said, God bless you, sir. He walked past and went down the street, come right back. And he said, you know what, man, I had a bad day. He said, I'm sorry for even calling you that. He said, because I know you're a human being. He said, would you accept my apology? I said, apology accepted. He went in his pocket and gave me 30 bucks and said, go get you a room and get you something to eat. You know what I mean? I mean, you know, no matter what people think about me, I know I'm a human first. And just because I'm down on my luck, don't give nobody no excuse to call me no bum. Because I'm not.